Chef Fitz in the building today again. Today we have a big menu plan put out for you, alright? So stay tuned because a lot of people going to learn how to cook Jamaican stew peas. Jamaican stew peas. So I have my peas from last night soaking down in some thyme and some garlic. So it basically cut down some of the cooking time. And also I have my pig steel over here cut up. In some water, so stay tuned today. Jamaican stew peas, all right. So, it's also gonna add 1/2 tablespoon to our peas while it won't cook for the next 30 minutes, all right. It's not gonna take long to cook because it was there soaking down for the last 24 hours, all right. So, you put it on, turn up your stove, allow the peas to cook. So we put our pig steel in some cold water, put it on the fire, and we're going to boil it. For the first 5 minutes, when it boils up, you basically throw up that water and you put it to boil again. Alright? Get out some of that salt. Alright, so here we start preparing some of our ground season. We have a few thyme there, scotch bonnet, we have cheek, clove of garlic that we mince up. And also we have our green onion, Bajan call it tribe, Jamaican call it scallion, right? It's the same thing. So we already pre-prepared this, alright? So we throw off our first set of water after 5 minutes. And then we're going to add back some more water to it. Add back some more water to it. And then we're going to place it back on the fire, alright? Fresh set of water, alright? So you check your peas, if you find that the water is going down, you add some more water to it, alright? Ensure that you can know when your peas soon cook. You take it up and you probably use a spoon and crush it. But you can add more water to it before the water extremely dry out. Just ensure that you add water to it, alright? So in the meantime, I prepare some dough, which I'm going to make some spinners to add to our steel peas, alright? The recipe for the dough, I basically gonna have it in my bio. It's basically flour, a little bit of cornmeal and salt to prepare our dough. So we pre-prepare our dough, which we're gonna make some spinners and add to our steel peas. So our peas is about 70% cooked, you know. I tell you, when you soak your peas, make your life far, far more different, yeah? Cut down the cooking time. Normally, the peas would take all an hour and a half. This is about 45 minutes and the peas almost cook already. Alright, you can take it up and you squeeze it and you see how it feels. Alright, so we're going to start add some stuff to it now. So our pigtail is actually come to a boil now. We'll throw off the water and then we're going to add it to our peas, alright? We're gonna add it to the peas. Alright, here we're adding our pigtail to the peas. Alright, add the pigtail to the peas. Looking good. Stir it. Stir it in. Then we add some more. Stir it on. After we add the pigtail, add one of our main ingredients, coconut milk. One of our main, normally use the grease coconut milk, but today I basically get a different one that we get from the store. Right, coconut milk. Stir it up. Coconut milk. Oh, one of the loving. This is talk about. All of the loving is in this. Alright, okay, so I'm gonna add some of my green onion, which is the scallion, a little bit of it, some of my garlic, and then some of my thyme, yeah, and then I add the scotch bonnet. Notice I leave the stem on the scotch bonnet. So you basically can remove it easy. Now you stir it. So you're gonna leave this to boil about 10 to 15 minutes, 10 minutes, and then I'm gonna add a few more stuff to it. All right. Alright, so we're going to add our spinners. So this was the dough that we prepared before. Roll it into this shape so we basically can drop them in. The reason why we call them spinners is probably the way we roll them. Yeah, drop in our spinners. Alright, so you put in all of your spinners and then you basically can stir it. Alright, so ensure that you stir it more often or not, because remember you have the coconut milk inside. Yeah, you don't want it start stick to the bottom. Yeah, because the cream from the coconut milk it basically cause it to stick. So ensure that you stir it. Looking good, eh? Yes, I'm gonna do a taste test and then I'm gonna see what I need to add to it. Alright, taste test. So I basically go after my taste test, I'm gonna add a little bit of all-purpose, maybe all-purpose, and some half teaspoon black pepper, 1 teaspoon all-purpose. Yeah, that's my first dry season I add to it. Remember I did seasoning and meat and all these things, you know. So we stir it, The black pepper give it that nice aroma, that taste. Alright. Why? Loving coming up. Alright. So finally we're gonna add our rest of scallion, thyme, and a little bit of carrot to it. Alright, that's our final addition to it. And we stir it. Make sure you stir it properly, you know. Hey, look, stir it nicely, you know. Put it on low heat. You can basically, put it on low heat and have it cook down for another 15 minutes. And then we're gonna see how it look. So remember to stir it ever so often, you know. Coming together now, it probably just want about 2 more minutes and it's good to go. Yeah, look at it. Yeah, look at how thick it is, yeah. I can't manage the water still piece. So just make it simmer down for about 2 to 3 more minutes. I mean, you're good to go, alright? So our stew piece is finally ready, yeah? Look at it. Beautiful. Alright. I'm gonna do my sharing. So there you have it. Jamaican stew peas in all its glory with thick tail. Alright? Remember guys, like and subscribe to Chef Fitzroy Needham on YouTube, Fitzroy Needham on Facebook, Fitzroy Needham on Instagram. Yeah? Check out our coming soon, some new menus, some new plan. I have 160 menu to put out within that within this quarantine season, yeah? So get with it. Remember, Jamaican food in all its glory. Big tail. Stew peas with big tail. Alright? Love it. Love you guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'm out.